Dr. Tom Rozelle live right now, 630 WMAL.
Remind you again, Thermography Centers of Fairfax, ongoing sponsor of Dr. Tom Rozelle Live. You can get a hold of Dareth Painter at 703-943-7248. Let's talk a little bit, and I'm going to go back because this is kind of on the subject. Our next callers that's lit up on the board here has. Talk a little bit about toxic reactions in the body. I'll start in, and then we're going to go to her phone call. There are multiple areas of toxicity that come from outside in. And what do we mean by that? Well, believe it or not, you have problems with genetic and inherited disorders, inherited toxins. You can actually pass toxins through the genetic matrix. And that was understood before, quite recently, meaning the last decade or so or a couple of decades. It was thought about, it was theorized, but they actually have data on that. Now, inherited toxic information, they're called miasms. And if any of you know homeopathy well, you understand that a lot of homeopathy is based on three primary constitutional remedies, and they're based on these miasms, these sets of predispositions, if you will. So we look at those. There's physical toxins, and those go everything from metabolic waste to free radical formation and digestive waste. Digestive means that your intestinal tract and your digestive system is not working the way it's supposed to, and it begins to build up poisons. You end up getting molds and fungus and bacteria that are laden in your intestinal system, and you end up with inflammatory disease, inflammatory reactions. You end up with much more of a reaction towards environmental allergies. Heavy metals and radon and pollens and plants, all the environmental pollutions, and then you've got the man-made stuff, right? All the xenoproblems, the xenoestrogens, the xenochemicals, pesticides, preservatives, smog, all that garbage out there. Biological organisms, viruses, bacteria, parasites, fungus. 60% of the population has parasites. And then the residuals of any drugs you've taken in your life, the inoculations, the antibiotics that you've taken, the steroids that you've taken, the NSAIDs that you've taken. The body doesn't get rid of all this stuff completely. You have residues of this stuff built up in your body, and it locks into the fatty storage areas, into liver function, into the skin tissue, and so forth. And unless you do something specifically to dump them, you don't get rid of them. By the way, there's something called mental and emotional toxins, and these are, the way you run your brain has a huge effect on your body. If your mind is polluted, your body's going to be polluted. Negative thoughts, hurtful thoughts, subconscious things, things are locked in. Learned behavior patterns, and it goes on. And then we end up with external energy field disturbances. The electromagnetic fields of different places of the earth, the electromagnetics of high voltage cables and your computer screens and TVs and your cell phones and your iPads and so forth, and radiation, X-rays, nuclear radiation. God forbid that we would ever end up like Japan right now. Ultraviolet radiation, and it goes on. And then you have disturbances in sound and disturbances in color. We know that there are sounds and colors that are very supportive of the body, things we don't think of, but they all have an effect. So it's important that not only your internal terrain, your body terrain, but your external environment are compatible, and that we work to begin to balance those things out. So we're going to talk a little bit about that as time permits before the program's over. But right now, Joan, you're waiting very patiently. How can I help you?
Good morning, Dr. Rozelle.
Hi.
I would like to back up your talk about ageless health. It was great last year, and I expect it'll be great this year.
Thank you.
My question is about glutens. You've spoken of them many times, of things to avoid. I've been tested for it, and I'm not sensitive to it. Should I still be avoiding it, and if so, why?
If you're not sensitive to glutens, then you're not going to react to them, unless you're allergic to them. Now, there's a sensitivity reactive pattern, and there's an allergic reaction pattern. So if you're allergic to wheat, which is a gluten, or rye is a gluten, and so forth, then you would avoid them. But if you're allergic to gluten itself, which is across many different things, then you have to avoid them totally. But there's an allergic pattern, and there's a sensitivity pattern. Having said that, if you're not allergic, or if you don't have a sensitivity to it, then you don't have to avoid them. I'm sorry, I've got to take a break. We're right up against the news, messages. I've got to take time for those who pay for the program. Be right back. This is Dr. Tom Rozell. You're listening to Dr. Tom Rozell Live. I've been at 888-630-WMAL. And as always, this program is way too short, and I'd like to apologize to our last caller for having to cut so close to the end of the program. However, let me make another comment on gluten. Gluten problems are pandemic in this country. More and more people are suffering from them today than ever before, simply because, thanks to Monsanto, so many things are genetically modified, and the amount of gluten in products are huge compared to what they used to be. So you anytime you get bombarded with a lot of somethings that are not supportive to your body, any substance that is marginal, you're going to become much more susceptible, much more inflamed, if you will, as gluten will do. But there are gluten allergies, there are gluten toxicities, and there are sensitivities. All of those things we're going to talk about in a different situation, in a different program later on. Gluten is not something that you want to put in your body if you don't have to, particularly if it's refined. Now, if you have no reaction to gluten, if you have no allergy to gluten, and you want some sprouted grain bread, you want some good oatmeal, you want some old-fashioned German rye bread, real stuff, go ahead. Just don't make it, you know, the largest portion of your diet. But I would encourage you to be careful if you are. If you know that you eat something that has wheat in it, if you know you eat something that has a gluten portion, and you know that's going to irritate you, why are you doing that to yourself? You're tearing up your intestinal tract. You're going to break down your body. You're going to leave yourself much more susceptible to other types of irritations that come from food and chemistry, and you begin to have problems across the board. Not a good thing, at least in my book. I don't know about yours, but I don't like hurting myself. You know, why don't you take the knife away and quit cutting yourself? It works that way. So gluten is not a bad guy across the board unless you're sensitive to it and just don't eat so much of it. Do you know that if you eat anything that's good for you, even lettuce, and it's organic, and you eat it all the time, you can become allergic to it? If you eat, a carrot, pretty soon you're going to be allergic to the carrot if you eat it every day. I have patients who juice carrots, and they drink 2 to 3 cups of carrots every day, and their skin and their hands are yellow. Well, that tells you something. You shouldn't do that. Your diet is meant to be well-balanced. We're going to have Sue on, and she and I are going to talk about nutrition and the whys and so forth and so on, and we're going to try to turn a light on the subject. You know, general considerations of eating healthy. And all of us, if we really cleaned ourselves up, we watched the environmental stresses, and we didn't get into the toxic reactions because I said this program is way too short. So if you want it longer, call WMAL. Tell them that you want Dr. Tom Rozell live on more often, and we'll give you many more intimate details of how to help yourself. I wish we had the time, but I want you to go to our website, go to RozellCare.com. You also can check the programs on RozellRadio.com, R-O-S-E-L-L-E, Radio, R-A-D-I-O.com, and you can get this program and all the other programs. Also go to Facebook, and if you don't have a Facebook account, that's okay. Go to RozellCare.com, and you hit our Facebook icon, and you go right in. And I blog there all the time, at least 2-3 times a week, with all kinds of different information. I'll be here next week, 12 noon, with a guest for your educational update. This is Dr. Tom Rozell. See you then. Bye. Hi, this is Dr. Tom Rozell. If you're looking for a wellness and healthcare environment to showcase your business, products, and services, consider being a wellness partner of Dr. Tom Rozell Live and the Rozell Center for Healing. From in-show advertising to on-site events and digital marketing, we have several offerings that can highlight your business with a well-received and established audience. For more information, visit WMAL.com, keyword Rozell, that's R-O-S-E-L-L-E, and click on Become a Sponsor.
Did you know that routine mammograms can increase radiation exposure to breast tissue 1,000 times over a chest X-ray? Now consider a simple, non-invasive, and totally safe medical procedure approved by the FDA since 1982 that can detect breast cancer 5 to 8 years before it can be visualized on a mammogram. Infrared thermographic imaging can accurately detect the initial signs of breast cancer as increased blood supply and metabolic rate, which is recorded as heat. Why expose yourself to radiation when accurate and safe medical detection is available? Call the Thermography Center of Fairfax to schedule a breast exam today at 703-948-7248. That's 703-943-7248. For more information, visit www.thermographyscan.net. That's thermographyscan.net for the Thermography Center of Fairfax.
The Roselle Center for Healing is a proud supporter of breast cancer awareness and reminds you to conduct a monthly breast self-examination and a thermographic breast scan as part of your annual wellness checkup.
Health is a do-it-yourself program. That's reality and the title of my new book. This is Dr. Tom Roselle. Health is a do-it-yourself program is a most understandable introduction to natural health care. My book will take you step by step through why the body breaks down and gets sick, but also how it repairs itself. You will finally understand the often confusing world of natural care. Order it today by going to Amazon.com or from our website, RoselleCare.com. That's RoselleCare.com.